Thank you. everybody. Thank you for being here tonight at the Focal Point. I'm Jake. I'm not TJ, as you might have noticed. TJ got ill and couldn't be here. So he's in quarantine. But the show must go on, right? And let me explain to you what's going on tonight. So this was kind of a show that we put together at the last minute. I didn't put it together at all, believe it or not. But we were going to do a recording session. So TJ had this idea. We're going to get these great musicians here, and we're going to have a recording session. We're going to videotape it. And then our friend Eric here at the Focal Point said, well, why don't we just invite everybody to watch? Why should we just leave you guys out on the street? So that's what's happening. You're going to watch history being made right here tonight. So just real quick, let me introduce the band here, because we got some really special musicians in the house tonight. Back here on the bass sax, we got Don Franz of the St. Louis Ragtimers. All right, and then we got Bill Mason, Wild Bill Mason, here on the trumpet. We got Glen Meyer on the clarinet. Bob Grimm on the banjo. They're the real stars of the show tonight. And Richard, too. And Richard Tralles on the bass. And me and Christian are just hanging out with our heroes tonight. So, if you don't know these musicians, they are local legends. They've been playing this music around town since at least the early 1990s, right?
1890s?
Okay, no 1890s. Let's do after you've gone. This is a nice, sweet tune in the key of B flat, but we're gonna start on the 4 chord, okay? Right? That's musician lingo.
No, bro. Yeah, I don't understand it.
All right, so it's going to be a little bit of banter between songs, because this is a recording session, so you're watching how musicians in the studio work here. And so we'll try to keep it clean for the audience, and try to keep all our clothes on. All right, you ready? Here we go.
So it'll be like...
This is how some of the greatest records in history were made, right here. All right, you ready?
Two, one, two.
That song was After You've Gone. The next one we're going to do here is, we're going to skip one. Actually, let me talk to Van for a second. All right. This next tune is going to be in the key of C. We're going to do the Darktown Strutter's Ball in the key of C.
C?
Yeah, C. Would you rather do B-flat, Bill?
No.
C or B-flat?
C.
All right, we're going to do it in C.
C, senor.
Now you know what it's like to be a record producer.
Hey, Bob, you got the first solo. We're going to go start with Bob this time and come my way. All right?
Here we go. Get this microphone out of my way here.
One, two, three.
All right, that was Bob with his cowbell. That's your invention, isn't it, Bob? Did you invent that? He did invent that, so patent pending, right? That's a good segue. Hey, Bob, will you sing a song for us? Okay. Bob's going to sing Sister Kate. All right. Yeah, right now I'm going to pass the mic down. But before you start singing, I was going to ask, since we got these great musicians on stage, I was going to ask them a couple of questions. Bob, will you tell us before you start singing, what was your first banjo job? Here, I'll get the mic down there for you.
First times I played banjo, I played with a four-piece, five-piece dance band consisting of two guitars, accordion, and drums, and sometimes sax, sometimes trumpet.
And what year was that?
1957. So I guess one of those times was my first time because I played the banjo for the Beer Barrel Polka and Bill Bailey.
There you go.
So I never thought of it that way.
So do you, Sister Kate, then? Do you want to do the verse or no?
Yeah, the piano will play along, I guess, in the case. This is called Arrangements While You Wait, folks. Okay.
Will you count it in as fast as
It was on one sunny morning, sun was shining bright. Lady love of a bone, Bill Bailey had her goes out on the line in her backyard and weeping hard. Married up being a brakeman, went and put her down, screaming like a prune-fed calf with a big crowd hanging around. Into that crowd, she yelled out loud, and she said, "Won't you come home, Bill Bailey? Won't you come home?" She moaned the whole night long. "You do the cooking, honey. I'll pay the rent. Rainy evening, I threw you out with nothing but a fine tooth comb, comb, comb. You know I'm to blame. Ain't that a shame? Oh, Bailey, won't you please come home?" Bill Bailey won't you come home? She moaned all night long. Who's the cooking, honey? I'll pay the rent. You know I've done you wrong. Remember that rainy evening I threw you out?
Ask him to sing. No, Glenn, tell us, what was your first jazz clarinet gig?
Well, I really started playing professionally on tenor.
Tenor? Oh, he was a tenor sax man.
Yeah, and I played in a rhythm and blues band. But the first jazz band I had was with Bill Mason.
With Bill?
Pete Patterson on banjo.
Oh, yeah.
John Chapman on piano. Bill Ruler on bass, Bobby Carnocker on drums, and Skip Derringer on trombone.
What year was that?
That'd be 1956.
19,000 same year, Bob. Yeah.
That must have been a wild town back then. A Jackovax Tavern, is that what it?
Well, that was on what? On Delmar?
No. On Manchester.
On Manchester.
On Manchester, not far from here, then, huh?
Yeah,
not
right.
Too far.
Okay. Next door to Skull and Steel.
Skull and Steel, whatever that was.
What was that, Richard?
Scott, my father was.
What was it?
It was a steel.
Oh, okay. Steel Foundry. That just sounds like a tough biker bar.
Pete Patterson.
So. Glenn's just telling me he played with the banjo player Pete Patterson. That was 1956. Pete Patterson was an African-American gentleman banjo player who played with Louis Armstrong
on
Fate Marable's Riverboat. That was in the 1920s probably. So you think these guys are legends? They played with the legends. You know? Yeah. Bill, you want to sing one for us? Will you do Alcoholic Blues? Since we're talking about taverns and margaritas. Sorry, kids.
Pick your key, Bill, whatever key you want.
What's that key we
have? C.
Actually, B flat.
B flat.
Check out what?
Yeah, that'll work.
B flat, that's good. Two flats.
Yeah, two flats. That's musician lingo again.
No sharps, just
no
flats.
Sharp. You don't play in those sharp keys.
Oh my god.
That's
it really comes later. After we had a few more lessons.
I'm getting one right now. Okay, Bill, B flat, the Alcoholic Blues, okay?
I got the blues.
You want to just play one, sing one?
Yeah, I guess we'll
okay.
If I forget the words, I'll just make them up, okay?
Okay, yeah.
It'll be something appropriate.
Yeah. Okay, you ready, Bill?
Blah, blah, blah.
We'll just play one in. One, two.
Thank you. I got the blues. Yeah, I got the blues. I've got those alcoholic blues. No more beer to bring my heart cheer. No more whiskey. Used to make me frisky. So long, highball. So long, gin. Tell me when you're coming back again. Amputated my booze. No more whiskey. No more. Not even a dollar will buy a pound of lager. So long, highball. So long, gin. Well, tell me when you're coming back again.
Listen, everybody. Bill, while we're here, I think you told me that your first professional job was on a riverboat, right? Is that right?
Well, one of the first.
Yeah. One of the... I think you said it was 1949 or something? 1948?
It would have been either 40, probably 48.
48. Tell us what about that job.
Well, it's probably the best job I ever had, even though it only paid...
Better than this one?
Well, yeah, I mean... even though there was four of us who got paid the tremendous sum of $25 a week, but all the food you could eat, you know, and even after hours you go down to the kitchen and have snacks and all that... And, sometimes there'd be even some ladies there, too, join. Young ladies. Of course, the young ladies took the short... They made 10-day trips to St. Paul and back, and then the other trips are a little bit longer down to Sheffield, Alabama, or Muscle Shoals, Alabama. Y'all know where that is?
Sure.
Really?
Muscle Shoals, that's where they cut all those rhythm and blues records, didn't they?
I don't know. Maybe you're thinking of Muscle Beach, California. I don't know. But yeah, we'd play during the dinner hour, and it was an actually old riverboat fair. Of course, they ran under diesel power. They didn't have burn coal like they did in the old days. But it had a paddle wheel on the back. I'm sorry, the stern.
For all you sea captains.
Yeah, I got to get it right. What else? And in between, we'd play bingo, or call the bingo numbers. And
wait, the band had to call bingo numbers?
Yeah, that was part of the...
You got your cards out?
What else? We had to put on little skits.
Did you have wardrobe changes and everything?
No, not too much. Let's see, what did we do? Little Nell is still alive, and the lighthouse keeper's daughter. And
I don't know if we can do those ones.
Those might not play today. I don't know. So that was 1948, you said. That's pretty. You win so far, Bill. You win the contest. We got to pick a song. How about this? This is a really good one. How about we do Dinah? Okay. All right. Dinah in the key of F.
Okay, Don. Dinah. All right.
Don, are you awake?
B-52.
Got it? One, two, three.
That's Glen on that hot clarinet. It's hot outside, but it's hot in here, too. Richard, will you sing a song for us?
Okay.
What do you like to sing there, Richard?
Let's do When You're Smiling.
Okay. Richard's going to sing one of my favorite songs, When You're Smiling.
It's going to be fun. I'm going to get the microphone back. This could take a minute now. Everybody bear with me.
When you're smiling.
Take a
whole minute.
This could take 6 or 7 minutes. Right.
Well, we all chip in and buy an extra mic.
Oh, no. I'm just kidding. All right, hey. I'm going to go over your head. Do this once a set, it's okay. While we're at it,
Don, what was your first gig? Do you remember your first gig, Don?
What was your first gig, Don?
Oh, I over in Europe, right? Germany?
Alphabet.
You played in Germany, though, didn't you, Don?
Yeah.
So Don used to play in Germany when you were in the service, right? What year was that? You remember?
Yeah, it was back
in the World War
early 60s, something like that.
1960.
About 1960, and you had a jazz group. St. Louis Ragtimers. I know you played with some other jazz group too in Europe, I think, for a while.
With Jeannie Kittrell.
Yeah.
Doc Kittrell.
With Doc Kittrell, that's right. Yeah. What about you, Richard? It's your turn.
My first gig?
Yeah.
It was at some bar in South St. Louis, and I felt like I was driving myself to my own funeral, I tell you. It was my own hanging, I think, actually. Okay. Well, when you're smiling?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm gonna get my trombone out.
How about the last date?
Yeah. Want everybody with you?
Yeah, let's all just do
everybody
last
on the
eight.
Last eight.
And then I'll start singing and
is the tape rolling, Eric?
Oh yeah.
All right.
Last
eight. All right. Everybody ready?
Yep.
1, 2, 3. When you're smiling, the whole world smiles with you. When you're laughing, the sun comes shining through. But when you're crying, you bring on the rain, so stop your sighing. Happy again, just keep on smiling, 'cause when you're smiling, the whole world smiles with you. Thank you. you're smiling, when you're smiling, the whole world smiles with you. When you're laughing, the sun comes shining through. But when you're crying, you bring on the rain. So stop your sighing and be happy again. Just keep on smiling, 'cause when you're smiling, the whole world smiles with you.
You see, this is how jazz music works. If we knew what we were going to do, it wouldn't be as good. Or as much fun, that's right. People come for the spontaneity, right, Bob?
They come.
Perfect. Thank you, everybody. We're going to take 15 minutes, and then we're going to be back again till 9 o'clock, okay? So go and get yourself some refreshments. Have a chat. Use the restroom. We'll see you in 15 minutes. Thank you.
Thank you.
you, everybody. That was Careless Love. I think W.C. Handy got credit on that. Is that right, Christian? All right. This is Christian Frommel on the piano, by the way. I might have missed him earlier on. Me and Christian are just hanging out. Yeah. What do you think, Bill? How about we do Some of These Days? Some of These Days.
Some of These Days.
You'll learn all jazz musicians have joke names for every song. Some of them we can say out loud and some of them we can't.
to a dance with my sister Kate.
Is that the best you could do?
I'll just leave it there.
Well, I went to a dance with my sister Kate. Everyone there said she danced so great. I realized a thing or two, and I discovered something new. I looked at Kate, she was in a trance, and then I knew it was in her dance, 'cause all the boys just going wild over Katie's dancing style. And I wish I could shimmy like my sister Kate. She shimmies like jelly on a plate. My mama wanted to know last night why all the Kate eating Kate's so nice. Now all the boys in our neighborhood, they know Kate shimmies and she shimmies good. I know I'm late, but I'll be up to date. If I could shimmy, yeah, shimmy just like Kate. If I could shimmy like my sister Kate. Know if I could shake it like Kate, I'd never come home till late. I'd drink my booze, I'd get as high as a kite. We could shimmy most any night. Kate shakes it sassy, shakes it mean, and she shakes it like a well-oiled machine. I know I'm late, but I'll be up to date. If I could shimmy, yeah, shimmy, and stay out late. If I could shimmy like my sister Kate.
Is that At the Banjo Palace? You inherited it from who?
I don't know.
Well, I bet they didn't do it that good, so.
Okay.
How about we do Strutting with Some Barbecue? Oh,
yeah. Bob's excited.
This one's going to be Strutting with Some Barbecue. This is Louis Armstrong and Lil Hardin, I think, tune, right, Christian? Yeah.
My friend.
What's that?
Can I start this one?
Yeah, go ahead. Is it an F?
It's an F.
Okay, then you can start it. Some barbecue.
You can't sing something.
Me?
You haven't sang yet.
Huh? This isn't about me, Mark.
Good evening.
Okay, okay. How about...
Mark's requesting I sing one. Okay. Exactly. How about... Yeah, that's right. We had a request for Exactly Like You. What's your key? You like B flat for that?
C.
C, okay. We're going to do...
I think Mark had two requests. Get out and stay out.
All right, Exactly Like You, we are going to do the key of C, and I'm going to sing it right for Mark, okay? I can sing in any key, Bill. It's going to be as bad either way. C.
Yeah. Have you thought about getting into opera?
Let's do Last Date, okay? I know why I've been blue. I wait each night for someone exactly like you. Why should we spend money on a show or two when no one does the love scenes exactly like you? You make me feel so grand. I wanna hand the world to you. You seem to understand each foolish little dream I'm dreaming. Scheme I'm scheming. Now I know why mother taught me to be true. She wanted me for someone exactly like Bill. So grand, I wanna hand the world to you. You make me understand each foolish little dream I'm dreaming, scheme I'm scheming. Now I know why mother taught me to be true.
She wanted me for someone like everybody. The time. We only have time for a few more songs. But we better make them good, right? Okay, let's do a really nice tune called My Buddy. My Buddy in the key. You want to take this one, Glenn?
Sure.
Do you know this one, Bob?
F. Give me four bars.
How many flats does F have? Remind me.
Three, four times.
That's a really nice tune that goes way back. My buddy. We are the St. Louis Rhythm Kings. That's the name of this band. Before we do our last couple of numbers, I want to introduce the band again. Bob Grimm on the banjo. You know him from the Banjo Palace, the Banjo Club, Jeannie Kittrell,
Muscles In,
Glen Meyer on the clarinet. You know him from Jack of Axe and every place in between. And Jeannie Kittrell, right? Yeah. And Bill, Wild Bill Mason, right here. I get to play with Bill on July 26th, right?
The what?
July 26th, we're going to be at the Sarah community, right?
Yeah, yeah. You better be there.
With Tom on drums. All right, we got... Oh, go ahead.
Son, the percussionist.
That's right. Don Franz on the bass saxophone. Richard Tralles on the bass, string bass. Christian Frommold on the piano. I'm Jake Allspach, filling in for TJ Muller, who put this whole thing together. This is all thanks to him and Eric and the Focal Point for doing this. I didn't do anything. I just showed up. So thank you to them. Thank you to you. This is a great crowd. I can't believe TJ would have had tears in his eyes seeing how many people came to see this. He told me, he said, don't be worried if no one shows up. And I said, I got a feeling, TJ. I didn't say that. All right, so how about
Jake, you did a wonderful job.
Oh, thank you, Bill. Thank you, Bill. All right, this is my first trombone gig in years, literally. You know, you come off a pandemic and then...
Multi-talented man.
Oh, thank you. How about we do the Tiger Rag? Can we do the Tiger Rag? All right. We'll see if we have time for anything after that. But let's do the Tiger Rag.
Let me see now. That's right. B flat, E flat, A flat.
I'm not sure about the arrangement.
You'll figure it out.
That's what we do here. You ready?
Well, let me see. You're going to figure it out ahead of time?
No, it just goes the way it goes.
The way it always goes. Here we go. You ready?
That's right.
Starts out?
Yeah. You ready?
That's how it starts.
All you got to do is wind it up, get it going, and then you'll be good. Here we go. One. I want to...
Thank you.
Thank you. That was a Tiger Rag. Thank you for coming out tonight. That's all we got. Somewhere, there's going to be a video and a recording of this. So we'll let people know, I guess. So thank you. Thank you, thank you. And thank you to all these great musicians for hanging out with me. Said we're going to try to do this again. So come back and see us again, okay?